Hi friends, Pete, K7PP, amateur call sign, and we're out in the shop working on the Collins 20V, and we're getting some power routed so that we can have an antenna relay. There are some holes already in existence for the transformer, which was supplying something else when we got the transmitter here. So we went ahead and used the existing transformer. And what we're going to end up with here is when 220 volts appears on that transformer, 6.3 volts will appear on the gray wire going up to the antenna relay, and 220 feed comes down in this bundle from the two wires that power the red light. So a real handy place to pick up the switched 220. So when that switch is turned on to supply the plate voltage, the red light comes on and the 220 comes down through the transformer and then up to the antenna relay on top of the transmitter. Well, we're still working on the arrangement to key the antenna relay for the 20V Collins. And I tell you what, I've been looking at the dial assemblies that has the red light for indicating high voltage plate application that comes on and turns red when the high voltage is on, and this light bulb, incandescent 10 watt bulb, and here's a socket for it. And if you take a look at it, I tell you what, I just cannot put this in the radio. This connector has got 220 volts applied to it, AC, and the only thing that protects it is a 6 amp 220 volt breaker. And you'll notice that I can just take a finger here and just move this guy around back and forth. It just kind of rotates, and the other side does the same thing. I can rotate it back and forth, and if it were to touch the mounting frame, that would put 220 volts positive on ground, and that would short circuit and kabang. So I can't put this back in the radio, and the green indicator is the same way. So I've ordered two industrial panel LED panel lamps that are protected and fused internally, and I'll be getting those in a day or two, and that's what's going to go in place of these things. They're not as pretty as the jewel pipe, but they're one heck of a lot safer. So unfortunately, we're not going to be able to stay with a stock, completely stock appearance, but c'est la vie, as they say. Well, bad news. Went to test my antenna relay, and it turns out that the transformer that came with the equipment has the 6.3 volt winding, which I'd counted on to drive the relay, is bad. The winding is okay. The 110 volt winding is okay, but the 240 volt winding is open. So, I guess I'm out of luck. Anyway, we've got another transformer coming, and hopefully this one will do the trick. Got the parts in for the panel displays. Here's what we got. These are rated at 220 volts, 15 milliamps, and definitely not going to short out. And we're going to go in and replace the green assembly with one of these. Here's the green assembly, and you can probably see why we're so twitchy about the whole thing. What we're looking at here is an assembly that has 220 volts on either one of these two wires, and the potential between one wire and ground is 110 volts. So 220 between here and 110 between here and ground, and here and ground, Just a fire hazard, looking for a place to happen. And we're going to do the same thing with the red indicator over here. That's going to come out, and we'll put the red indicator in place right there and wire it up. And it'll rest a lot better at night. Okay, there we go. Doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look like the jewel that was in there, but I'm thinking it's going to be an awful lot safer and pretty easy to connect up. Everything is much better insulated. Just put the bare wire in the hole, turn the screw, and you're done. Well, that doesn't look too bad, does it? Those are the new light bulbs, panel bulbs, and transmitter looks like it's working really good. Low power setting, 600 watts output, and a little over 200 milliamps plate current. Yep, not too bad. Sure hope we're coming down for the finish line here. We're in the back of the transmitter. Install a couple of inline fuses, and we're going to be wiring up the front panel light and the 220 feed that comes out of the power supply. I've got to solder and heat shrink them and connect up to these fuses, and then the two fuses will supply the transformer that converts 110 down to approximately 12 volts or so to run the antenna relay. And I'm putting in two fuses because should the transformer ever fail, either one side or the other to ground, it'll only blow the fuse and not blow up the house. So anyway, maybe we're being a little bit overly cautious, but I don't think so, not with these things. Okay, we've got everything all wired up and tie wrapped out of the way. And all I've got to do is put the transformer on the front side of the lower panel. And we've got the double fuses. It's kind of interesting. I'm sure that this thing was built before they even had tie wraps. And the more I look at it, the more I realize that probably before they even had color coding. Man, this is a real hard one to trace out. But I think we're there, and we'll wire up the transformer and light it off and see what we get. And here we go with the transformer mounted. And when the 220 appears on that transformer, we'll get voltage that'll go up to the antenna relay and key it as soon as the red light goes on. Well, here is the final test. Got the filaments all warmed up. Got the antenna relay hooked up, the new antenna relay. And it's going to be a simple test. I turn the transmitter on and I get 600 watts or I don't. That's pretty simple. Okay, hold your breath. Oh my, how sweet it is. All right, let's check VSWR. Make sure there's no reflected. And there is not. Again, score, as they say. Okay, well, I pronounce this thing ready to get hooked up to a receiver and go on the air. Now all I gotta do is move it down to the operating position. That'll be fun. That's about 1,500 feet away from this location. Well, maybe I should just make another video about that. This is Pete, K7PP, and we're almost there.